Greetings, everybody. This is Archangel McIntosh, aka Mikael Israel, Archangel Michael, Mayakal. I hope you guys are having a wonderful day today. In today's video, we're going to be learning about the warrior side of the Creator, because as you guys know, the Creator is in charge of both sides and all sides, like a body with a right arm and a left arm. You see, so the Creator would be the body that both arms are connected to, and that arm, that body would pretty much be Ahaya, the Most High. Good would be its right hand, the righteous, and the bad would be its left hand. You see, that's why when you pray, you bring right and left together. You see what I'm saying? So today we're going to learn about the warrior side of the Creator, how it helps us eliminate our enemy, whether it's spiritual, energetic, emotional, or physical. It gives us the strength and the power within the word I am, Ahaya, to eliminate all threats that may come in a divine, orderly way. Because there is a positive way to kill and there is a negative way to kill. And I'm going to reference it from the Bible itself today for you guys, so you don't think I'm making things up. So, because remember, the Creator isn't biased. It doesn't choose one thing over the other. It just do not like wickedness. Now, you protecting yourself from an intruder or a demon, and you kill him or something, in the act of defending yourself because a demon was attacking you, you know, that's not the same as wickedness. Actually, that beast was wicked enough to try to come after you like that. It need to be slain. You see what I'm saying? So we're going to go, this is going to be a very humble one. You know what I'm saying? It's going to be very humble. It's not going to be all like warlike, gore-like, because the Creator is not wicked. Once again, it is righteous. It works according to justice and to order and harmony. And certain things aren't in harmony, so it eliminates it like a cancerous cell. You see, so let's go ahead and begin. Well, before we begin, I do want to say Halalahaya, 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 which mean all praises to the Most High I Am. Bahasham Yashayai, Bahasham mean in the name of, or coming in the name of, and pardon me, Yashaya pretty much means Savior, Redeemer, the truth, the peace, the love, the light. Christ also means Savior too, so in Hebrew, Yeshaya pretty much means Savior. So Ahaya, Asher, Ahaya, I am that I am. Bahasham, coming in the name, Yahashai, in the name of Christ, the Redeemer of peace, love, and light. Halalahaya, Barakanta, bless you, bless you. Shalom, shalom, shalom. May there be peace on earth. May we all be set free from our bondage. May we receive what we need to receive from you, Almighty, to be who we need to be and be in our deepest sense of I am. May we know who we are. May I continue to know who I am, and may you continue to be who you are. I am that I am. We call on you, Archangel Mayakal, Michael, Mikael, from the north gate, from the south gate to protect us. We call upon you, Archangel Auroral. We call upon you from the north gate to protect us and give us devotion, spiritual devotion, healing, love, connection with nature. We call upon you, Archangel Gabriel, Gabawayel, the Archangel of the East. We call upon you to protect us and teach us how to remain humble and still. And we call upon you, Archangel Raphael, Rapha, Alpha, the healer. We call upon you, Archangel Raphael of the West, to heal us, to protect us, to guide us, and keep us safe. May all four archangels of the four quadrants of the universe be with us now as we go through this journey. Protect us from anything that may not serve us, and eliminate the things that stand in our way, that hamper our movement, that blocks good from coming in, so we can let good, prosperity, abundance, joy, happiness, success, bliss, safety come in. Aman, aman, and aman. Om. Thank you. All right, let's go ahead and play some of this music. Let's go ahead and begin. Pardon me. Boom. All right. Jeremiah 51. Calling on all the warriors of light. Calling on all the 12 tribes of Yesharallah, Israel. We are calling upon you, the chosen people of Christ, the chosen people of the Redeemer, of Ahaya, Bahasham, Yeshaya. We are calling you so we can reunite the army to protect ourselves from the intrusion to come. Archangel Michael is here and has arrived. We are here with you. We will lead you through this battle. Your words is your sword, and your heart is your gun. Your mind is your weapon. Begin to use it. Your words, your heart, your feelings, and your mind. Get ready for war. We're in the end times. Salacha. Jeremiah 51. Thus says Ahaya, behold, I will raise up against Babylon, against America, and against them that dwell in the midst of them, that rise up against me, a destroying wind. Whoever standing against the greatest I am presence, the greatest I am that I am, will be punished, destroyed, annihilated, eliminated, eradicated, completely erased out of the book of life itself. Therefore, we must obey the laws and the commandments of the Most High, which is based on natural law, common law, universal law. The Ten Commandments is that. And Ahaya will send unto Babylon, America, and all the other ones copying Babylon, which mean the war countries, all of them, wherever they are. Can be in the Middle East, they can be up north, wherever they are. Whoever is against the Most High is called Babylon. So, and we'll send them to Babylon, winnowers. If you don't know what that means, look it up. Winnowers. That shall winnow her, and shall empty her land. In the day of trouble, Jacob's trouble, they shall be against her round about. So many people is going to surround Babylon, which is America and all the bad countries, and they're going to destroy it. They're going to destroy them. You see what I'm saying? So whoever the creator is empowering to do that already have the power now. It's coming. They have given the power. They have been given the power of death and destruction to eliminate a certain group of people. 2/3. And they will die. And they will not see this video. And they will not be warned or alarmed. Because for some reason, we can't change what is written. It must happen like it always have. This is prophecy being fulfilled. So against him that bends, let the archer bend his bow. And against him that lifts himself up in his armor, and spare you not her young men, destroy you utterly all her army. So don't worry about if they're young. Don't worry about if they're old. Annihilate them. Eliminate them, and they will destroy her utterly. So these nations that are against I am Ahaya, the most greatest I am, and their worshiping idols will be completely destroyed, utterly destroyed by an army that might be big in number or small in number, but have the power of the I am, the Most High, to eliminate these people, because the Most High owns us. The Most High created us. The creation can never be greater than the Creator. How can your drawing be much greater than you? It can either be equal to you because it's your drawing. It's equal to your thoughts and beliefs and values. Or it's less than you because you created it. The pen's in your hand. The eraser's in your hand. Like, you give a dang what a picture and your drawing have to say? No. If it's causing harm in the picture, it must be erased. So these people will be blanked out, wiped out while they're screaming. You got to repent. So against him that bends, let the archer bend his bow. And bow can also represent missiles because it has a point of a bow, or it can also mean bullet because it has a point of a bow. You see, so it can be missiles that they're launching at us, as if they're archers launching an arrow. You see, because we don't use arrows in today's time. What is similar to an arrow, or you know, to a bow, an arrow, a gun, bullets, or a missile? They didn't say bomb. And against him that lifts himself up in his armor. So those who try to put themselves in their armor and protect themselves from this time will not be spared, nor will the young, and her whole army will pretty much be destroyed, a whole nation again, like the kingdom of Greek fell, and the Roman Empire fell, and the Egyptian Empire fell, and all this stuff. Eventually, the Hebrew Israelites had fell, and now we're on the rise again. Kwam Yasharallah. So against him that bends, let the archer bow, bend his bow. Thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans. Chaldean mean those who keep things in secret, like Illuminati. So the lands of the Illuminati, which would be England, which would be Arab, and all the nations that's united under the New World Order, United Nations, all of them are considered Babylon. You see what I'm saying? Because Babylon multiplied itself by mating with people from all the countries all around the world. So now every country is going to kind of get hit and punished because they drunk of her wine. They taste of her bosom. You see what I'm saying? They taste her breast, drunk her milk, and now they're deeply embedded in her and lost in her. We're lost in wickedness here. You see? So a lot of things have to be eliminated because some of us are cancers without knowing it. So we need to move out the way so the good can remain and repopulate. Like vitamins eliminating bad enzymes in your body and turning them into positive enzymes, which eventually start to populate and make your body heal and heal thee. So the land of the Chaldeans will be the land of the Illuminati, the Luciferic people, people keeping things a secret, the Catholics, the Christians, all that stuff. Thus the slain shall fall in the land of the Chaldeans, in the land of America, England, Arab, and they that are thrust through in her streets. For Israel, Yasharallah, has not been forsaken. So the 12 tribes of Israel still have the covenant with the Creator. They will be protected if they listen to the commandments. So Israel has not been forsaken, nor Judah, Yahawada, which is us people in America, the so-called Negroes in the Moors, by Ahiah of host, though their land was filled with sin against the Holy One of Israel, Yasharallah, which is pretty much Yeshaya, Christ, Emmanuel, Immanuel, the God Ahiah is with you. So now the Creator says, now this is the command to you that are the believers of the Most High. Even if you're a Gentile or don't know if you're a Gentile, you too, if you listen to the commandments and have the Most High in your heart, which is I am, it will guide you, it will protect you, it will sustain you, it will clothe you, it will do everything for you, through you, with you. You see what I'm saying? If you allow the great I am Ahiah, Asher Ahiah, to work through you in the name of Yeshaya, which is the Creator Ahiah manifested in flesh itself, Yeshaya. You see? So if you take these commandments and listen and don't act based on fear, you will be protected. But if you act based on fear, you might leave at the wrong time, you might leave too early, or you might go exactly where you're going to die. So fear will not help you during this time. It must be left behind. It was a mind control mechanism that they planted in us that do not exist. I mean, what is fear other than a lack of embracing, the lack of accepting, the lack of appreciating what's in front of you that you're facing? That's all fear is. You have to appreciate each moment. That's what prayer is. Giving appreciation, gratitude, and thankfulness. And giving it all back to the Most High, because this is all borrowed. Not to keep, but to borrow and return like a loan with a mortgager. So literally, that's the Most High. The Most High have many positions in existence, because he can go in and out of form. He or she or he, she or it can go in and out of form because it is pure, raw energy in the form of I am. Now that I am. So this is the command. Flee out of the midst of Babylon, these bad, wicked cities. Flee out of them. Flee out of them. Flee out of Europe. Flee out of Arabia. Flee out of Israel. Flee out of America. Flee because the creator's coming and it's going to smite them across the neck, which means it's going to cut them by the sword. They're going to die by the sword because why? They live by the sword. Now, the sword does not mean the sword literally. It can mean the bullet. It can mean a missile. It can mean getting their ass whooped and beat pretty much. Pretty much again, they're going to fall by the hand of what they make others fall into. You see, so if you're wicked, you'll be judged with wickedness. If you're righteous, you will be judged with righteousness. You see, so those who live by the sword will die by the sword, and those who don't die by the sword and those who don't live by the sword will not be killed by the sword. They'll leave here a different way, by whatever way they live by. Your way will kill you. So flee out of the midst of Babylon and deliver every man his soul. Yeshaya, deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity, in her sins and wrongdoings and her wickedness. For this is the time of Ahijah's vengeance. The time of Ahijah's vengeance. The creator has the right to do that because it is the Almighty. It is the only being with the pen and the eraser to the existence of your life, your story, your blueprint, your physical presence and your soul presence and spiritual presence. It can eliminate it all and take back his breath from you, like, give me back my stuff. I am going to foreclose on you. So this is the time of Ahijah's vengeance because we did not keep our promise to pay back. He will render unto her a recompense. Babylon has been a golden cup in the highest hand. So Babylon, America, when we used to be missionaries and go across the world and promote God and Christ and all this stuff, we had a good heart. Now America is using that to steal money from people. Hey, donate to Haiti. And they never give the money to Haiti. They give it to their military people for their people. Or donate to these starving kids in America. Look at them. I mean, these starving kids in Africa. Look at them. Help them out. Talking all calm and sincere. These smooth sayers. But then they take the money and use it for themselves. Never gave to Africa. Why do you think all these countries are still broke and poor? Ponder this. Ponder this. It is a scheme. It is a scam. And they have duped you into donating into their fucking idea. Pardon my language. Forgive me. But before they started doing that, they used to give the money to Haiti and those kids that need it. They used to actually work for peace and give to Africa and Jamaica and stuff like that. Now they're raping it. Buck wild. Raw naked. So they fell. They are no longer the golden cup in the highest hand that made all the earth drunk now. The nations have drunk of her wine because now it became something to drink. Everyone want to be like Americans. Everyone want to dress up like Americans. Everyone want to act like Americans. You know what I'm saying? To the point where everyone drunk of her wine. So now they're drunk of her. About to throw up, puke her out, and purge. Therefore, the nations are mad. The nation, so speaking about nation, nationality, as you know, America is a nation. So now we are mad. Yeah, we went crazy. Now we're angry. Now we're furious. Now we're in pain, agony, disconfidence, slavery. We can't think for ourselves. We've been dumbed down, all this stuff. We have went mad. Like someone who's drunk and cannot think and speak. They're slaggering and everything. They can't speak right. That's how some of you guys sound now. Like zombies. Some people are mental zombies. They're not controlling their brain. They're not controlling their mind. They're not controlling their spirit. And most of all, their I Am presence, which is the Most High. They're completely disconnected from I Am, that I Am. Ahijah, Asher, Ahijah. So Babylon, America, Europe, Islam, China, all that stuff that have been feeding into the negativity and the againstness of I Am to serve idols and people and Jesus, which is Zeus. Babylon has suddenly fallen. They have suddenly fallen, suddenly, blow, and destroyed. Wail for her. Take balm for her pain. If so, be she may be healed. So something big's gonna happen to these places. So therefore, this is the vengeance of the Most High, which is in Jeremiah 51, section 6 and 7 and 8. So, all right, section 9. We would have healed Babylon, America, but she is not healed. Forsake her, because we won't repent. The only way to heal is to repent. We won't admit the wrongdoings that we caused. We won't admit how we had strayed away from the Most High and fell for Jesus' flesh, which is a white man with blue eyes and long hair, whatever, blonde hair, all this stuff, and have not known the Creator and fell for Jesus and stuff, but won't admit that we've been lied to by the whole Jesus mission, which was a plot by the Vatican, the Roman Vatican, the Roman Catholic Vatican, which is from Europe, which have created Catholic, which is Satanism, you know, and Islam, and which is Allah, and created Christianity, which is Jesus, Zeus, and all of it leads back to the Vatican. The Vatican is Lucifer. They are the devil. The Pope is the devil. The priests are the devil. And you guys have to know that. They're no longer the holy people because they had fallen. And those who are still following these people, not seeing that they fell off, you see, are falling with them because they're drinking of their words. They're drinking of their wines and their emotions and the lies that they're making up. Or believe in the higher, believe in Jesus, when clearly in all the scriptures, the Creator says, I am that I am. So where are you getting all these other things from? That's another study though. So let's continue. Babylon is suddenly fallen and destroyed. We would have healed Babylon, but she is not healed. Forsake her and let us go, everyone, into his own country. Now we're going to be being led to the promised land, the promise that the Creator had gave. So this is all happening in order for the system to fall apart so we can be led to the promised land, where the Most High had promised us through the covenant made with Abraham, Jacob, Isaac, Isaac, Moses, King David, and all of them. That is our bloodline, dark-skinned people. That is our bloodline. That is our truth. All dark-skinned people before the white man, the Vatican, pardon me, had came onto this earth and controlled us through his European factions and Ashkenazi Jewish factions, which is this European facets. The tribe of Edom, the tribe of Edor, the not chosen one. So for her judgment reaches unto heaven and is lifted up even to the skies. So her torch, her charges, her sins are lifted up all the way up to the skies, piled high, because we thought that we're getting away with things, but now there's so much to clean because we just kicked things under the rug or we piled it up in the closet and now we have to address it and stuff, or all of it's going to fall down like a bomb on us with the same intensity of how high it is. And that's not good. That's not good. The higher your sin, the harder it's going to fall if you don't start repenting them each one by one. You see, eventually when you repent one by one, ask for mercy and forgiveness, and give your soul and heart back to the one that created you, the Most High I Am, then you will start to be cleansed new, as if it was never there. You'll start fresh. And if you start to sin again, it'll start to pile up again, and quicker this time. So you must live in the way. Ahaya has brought forth our righteousness. Come and let us declare in Zion the work of Ahaya, our Most High, the Most High. And Zion also been infiltrated, or is ran by the Vatican as well. They're ran by the Ashkenazi Jews, which is the Khazarian Jews, Khazars. They're the fake Jews, the ones you call rabbi, that rabbles all the time. And they changed up our ancient Paleo Hebrew to modern Assyrian Hebrew. You see what I'm saying? Which is Arab, Syrian Hebrew. So Arab is pretty much rabbi still. All these people come from up north near the Caucasus Mountains, where the Caucasians come from and things like that. You know, there's so much things they're not even telling white people about their own history too. You're not white, no one's black. There's no such thing. Those are adjectives for energetic states of being. You know, his energy is black or his energy is white. That's what that means. But as far as race and nationality, white and black is not a race and nationality. Or you forgot what colors are. You might need to go open up a crayon box again and realize that black and white's a crayon. It's a color. It's an adjective. It's racist prejudice. So the system is still fully racist today. So Ahaya has brought forth our righteousness. Come and let us declare in Zion the work of Ahaya, the Most High. Make bright the arrows. So make bright, like missiles, they're bright. Bullets, they're bright. Gather the shields. Ahaya has raised up the spirit of the kings of the Medes. So now if you don't know who the Medes are, you need to research that real quick. Pause this and research it and figure it out, because the Most High, Ahaya, has raised up the spirit of the kings of the Medes. So that might explain why the Islamic people are here to destroy a lot of things. And the people that are destroying things are here, like Obama and all them. They've been appointed to punish us. They've been appointed over us. It says that in the curses too, in the covenant, if we break them. So it's happening. This is why it's happening. All this feeling and disaster and shit. For his purpose is against Babylon, these wicked people, to destroy it, because it is the vengeance of Ahaya, the Most High, the vengeance for his temple, which is the consciousness. The temple is the consciousness, which is his, the mind, the heart. Your heart is your temple. You see what I'm saying? That is where you dwell. That is the church. Now, if you can have a group of people externally in an external temple, in an external church, and you use that body of that building to worship the Most High and connect with the temple of the self, the great I am, then you're doing good. But if the temple of the external temple, the church and all that stuff, the group gathering, does not connect you with the great I am and with the inner temple, you're not in the temple yet. So rather you're in the temple mentally and you are in the church with your heart emotionally than being in the church externally and not being with the I am. Because you'll end up worshiping the preacher over time and not know it. Yearning and teaching for answers, but he keeps reading you pages that's not relevant to now. You see what I'm saying? Sometimes he do, some things stand out, but what's most vital is not being explained to you, because only I am can tell you the truth, which is your intuition. For his purpose is against Babylon. So set up the standard upon the walls of Babylon. Make the watch strong. Set up the watchmen. Prepare the ambushes. The watchmen will be the spies. People listen to our phone calls, the NSA, all that stuff. The whole system. You know, Facebook, to watch us, to stronghold us, to make the slavery more intense until we repent. Until we repent. So prepare the ambushes. Now they're setting us up, trying to process us through court quick, making us sign contracts and certain agreements and stuff so they can destroy us through the system. And not only that, too, physically as well, because they're preparing to hit us again like they did the Boston bombings and the 9/11 building bombings, which was an inside job, and the school shooting, the Columbine, all that stuff was an inside job. And them lying about nuclear bombs being in Iraq or Afghanistan, and then come tell us, you know, tell us that there's bombs and nuclear weapons there, and it's such a great declaration from someone who's supposed to be honorable, but then come back and dishonor it by saying that, oh, it was an accident, we thought they had it. How can you make such a big mistake in such a gigantic declaration without thoroughly thinking about it? You know, so I guess his mouth slipped and he said something big, and they said, if you don't go reverse it, we're gonna kill your ass. So he had to go tell you, George Bush had to go tell you that they didn't find any nuclear weapons, but they have it there. They're getting ready to come. They're getting ready to come. That's why they lied about it. So they're preparing the ambushes. For Ahaya has both purposed and done that which he spoke against the inhabitants of Babylon. So the good and the bad is the both. O you that dwell by many waters, abundant in treasures, your end has come, and the measure of your covetousness. So you that dwell by many waters can also mean the coastlines, because when they launch nuclear weapons and the earth start to shake and earthquakes start to happen through the weather machine, HAARP, and everything starts shaking and they're causing all types of weathers all in one day, and their machine get jammed and just out of control, you know what I'm saying? The water's gonna rumble across the earth like a boat rocking on the ocean. So the continent will be the boat, and the ocean would be what's around the continent. So now when the boat's rocking, it's going to cause the waves to splash to a point it starts going inside the edges of the boat, which is the coastline. So whoever's on the coast are going to get wiped out if you're at the edge where there is many water. O you that dwell by many waters, like Florida, Boston, Connecticut, New York, and a couple of other places. will be underwater completely. Do some research, man. Oh, man. Your end has come in the measure of your covetousness. Ahiah of hosts has sworn by himself, saying, surely I will fill you with men as with locusts, and they shall lift up a shout against you. So they're coming for us. There's going to be men placed on our land, foreigners. Like now the whole system, court system, is ran by Admiralty, which is people who live based on England. They're registered with the Bar Association, the British Admiralty Registry, BAR, British Admiralty Registry. You are registered to be a British citizen through the birth certificate in the Social Security. So now we have all these foreigners here on our land based on contract. And they're taking over our land already through McDonald's and all these international courts and restaurants, fast food, and international presidents, international television shows, and international artists. Everything's internationalized now. It's a nation within a nation within a nation. A government within a government. So will it be filled with locusts, which are all plagues, and they shall lift up a shout against you. He has made the earth by his power. So the Most High made the earth by its own power, not because of you, not by you. You didn't make this land, nor did I. I surrender to the Most High's will. He has established the world by his wisdom, wise dominance, and has stretched out the heaven, the sky, by his understanding. When he utters his voice, the thunder, bow, there is a multitude of waters in the heavens, in the sky, the rain. So when it thunders, the multitude of waters is rain. And he causes the vapors to ascend from the ends of the earth. He makes lightnings with rain and brings forth the wind out of his storehouses. So the Most High is controlling weather. Even though men try to replicate it, he'll just vex the natural weather of the earth and get wiped out. Every man is senseless by his knowledge. Every goldsmith is confounded by the graven image, the idols. For his molten image is falsehood, which is Obama. And there is no breath in them, the government. They have no spirit, because breath means spirit in life. They have no spirit or breath. Not just the government, but many people. So you're going to see a lot of the devil's minions, the ones without breath, the ones without soul and heart, reuniting, as well as the righteous. So we're being separated right now automatically. You will lose a lot of people that don't serve you no more in your life. And you will be meeting a lot more people that serve you in your life, or a lot more situations and circumstances that will serve you and benefit you. If it's not with people, because we're not here for people, we're here to do the Most High's will on earth as it is in heaven, as commanded. They are vanity, the work of errors. In the time of their judgment, they shall perish. So dollars, all that stuff is idols. They're vanity and they are works, something that someone worked on, but they're a work of errors, because man is corrupted. How can we create something beautiful when we're corrupted? We're full of evil and sin and wickedness, and we don't want to admit it. That's what makes us even more wicked. To say you're not wicked is wicked itself. Even the Most High, Yeshua, had to say that he also is a sinner. But he wasn't a sinner. You see what I'm saying? Because he knew he was a sinner, he did not do it. He never fell for it. You see, but us, we're sinners, but we don't even want to admit we are. Christ Yeshua didn't walk around just saying, I'm not a sinner. He knew the flesh is a sinner. He knew the flesh is a sinner. So he faced the temptations to beat it and gave us the way. The directions of how to beat it ourselves within. To go inward. So they are vanity, dollars, all the idols, Jesus, not Christ, but Jesus, Zeus, Hercules, Baal, Baal, Malkot, all these things. All these things will be fallen and stuff. All these graven images, they have no power. All power is in the Most High. In the time of their judgment, they shall perish. The portion of Jacob, Israel, is not like them. So the ones who are from the tribes of Jacob, which is Israel, because Jacob was renamed Israel, and in Hebrew is called Yisraelah, which is Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel, is not like them. Which means we're not like these people. Like, there's something wrong with them. They're sick. They're strange. They get stranger. You see what I'm saying? That's why they're strangers. Because their beliefs are weird. Sacrificing babies and having sex with each other. Gay sex and gay marriage and orgies in a cathedral and a synagogue of liars and blasphemous people. Like, what? These boys are wild. Someone need to put some judgment upon their butt. And this is what the Most High is doing. Oh, believe that. Those who are wicked will pay, and so will their nation. And those who are righteous that stay within that place will be hurt by it too. But because they're righteous, it will hurt them lesser. That's all. But if they get out of there, they won't be a part of that plagued area, the infested area, their virus. So the portion of Jacob is not like them, for he is the maker of all things, and Israel is the rod of his inheritance. So Israel, the land, is the rod of Jacob, and that is Jacob's inheritance. And in Jacob has been blessed. There's a covenant between Jacob and the Most High, just like Isaac. So all the nations that reunite with their ancestors, Jacob, Abraham, necessarily Jacob and Isaac, Isaac, then they will also inherit the land in the promise that the Most High Ahiah of hosts had promised. So Ahiah, the Most High of hosts, is his name. And we are the host. We are guests in the Most High's home. You are my battle axe and weapons of war. For with you will I break in pieces the nations. So us, we are given this power to fulfill the prophecies of the Most High, like the Most High gave King David the power to eliminate a lot of people. And some of it wasn't necessarily what these ignorant people would call positive, because positive and negative don't exist in the Most High. Everything is based on cause and effect. What must be done must be done. If you're constantly saying something's negative, then you won't see the positive in it. And if you're constantly saying something's positive, you'll miss out the negative in it. So positive and negative is a distraction. It blinds you. So the certain things that the Most High appoint people to do and things to do has nothing to do with positive and negative, heaven and hell. You actually go to hell if you don't obey what the Most High tell you. You go to heaven when you obey every command that the Most High tell you, even if it tells you to kill your own child, which it had tested Abraham to do. You see, Abraham was tested with that. And then right when Abraham was about to do it, the Creator said, no, stop, don't do it. I know that you believe in me now because you are willing to sacrifice your child, everything that you have for me, to give away everything that you have for me, to sacrifice it all for me, like Christ had did and died on the cross for us and took 3 nails to his body, lashing, whippings, everything, sped on, called names, and still stood humble. I know that you believe in me because of that. So the Creator said, put down the knife. I'm going to send the sheep for you to slaughter instead to make the covenant with me on this altar. So we used to make sacrifice too, to the Most High. So the sheep came by, him and his child, honorably sacrificed the sheep, made the covenant with the Most High, like the Most High said, and boom, covenant was made. He was worthy, faithful, and loyal to the unseen, to the Most High, the Spirit. So when you don't obey the commands, if he didn't almost stab his kid, then he would be marked as an unfaithful person, and the history wouldn't have been named after him or Christ. So sometimes bad things have to happen in order for greater things to come in. Some of us have to lay down for greater things to step in and come in. So a lot of people is going to be laid down. A lot of people is going to be kept up. A lot of people is going to still exist. A lot of people is going to be eradicated spiritually, as a soul, and physically. So I don't know who you with. Get ready. Ahiah, Asher, Ahiah, Bahasham, Yeshaya. Christos, 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 Yeshaya, 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 Ahiah, I am. I am. Let's continue. You are my battle axe, Ahaya, and weapons of war. For with you will I break in pieces the nations, the enemy, the threat. And will you, and with you, I will destroy kingdoms, kings, and all of them that are against you. And with you will I break in pieces the horse and its rider. And with you will I break in pieces the chariot and its rider. With you also will I break in pieces man and woman. And with you will I break in pieces old and young. And with you will I break in pieces the young man and the maiden. I will also break in pieces with you the shepherd and his flock. And with you will I break in pieces the farmer and yoke of oxen. And with you will I break in pieces captains and rulers. And this has happened many times. And I will render unto Babylon all the foul, wicked, heathenish, Gentile, atheist places, and to all the inhabitants of Chaldea, all their evil that they have done in Zion in your sight, says the Lord Ahaya. Behold, I am against you, O destroying mountain, says the Lord Ahaya, Adon Ahaya, who destroy all the earth, and I will stretch out my hand upon you, and will reach out for you and touch you, and roll you down from the rocks, throw you down from your pedestal, from your thrones, kick you down, and will make you a burnt mountain. So you kings, you guys who think you're above the Most High, it is your end now. I hope you are hearing. And those who are here to fulfill their end, be with me now. I am with you, Emmanuel, Immanuel, Yeshaya. I am the Redeemer. Not this flesh, the spirit of I am within you. Proclaim, I am has sent you now. Or behold, I am against you if you don't. And they shall not take of you a stone for a corner, nor a stone for foundations, but you shall be desolate forever. So that means the currency of the United States is going to crash. The currency is going to fall. People's going to lose faith in us. People will stop using our money. People will start buying our things and stop selling to us all across the border. Just a complete exile. Complete exile. Like, you guys had messed up. We don't want to have anything to do with y'all. Y'all tricked us. Y'all took away our culture. Y'all took away our traditions. Y'all deceived us. Y'all blasphemed. Y'all committed perjury. Y'all coerced us. Y'all forced us. Man, don't you cops see this? Don't you judges see this? Don't you presidents and governmental people see it? Regardless if you believe in good, your belief is not overwhelming your action. So your action is going to cause you to be exiled and desolate. And I know the world of America will not hear this in the wicked people in the Babylon. They refuse to hear it because the name of Christ, which is truly Yeshaya, has been slandered and defamed and has been altered to the point where people are sick of hearing it. They're desensitized and they think Yeshaya has something to do with a cross and something physical, or a church or a pastor or a priest, or has to do with necessarily a book. But it doesn't. It has to do with what's in your heart, what is in your consciousness. That is the return of Christ, because Christ was a consciousness. Set you up a standard in the land. Blow the trumpet among the nations. Prepare the nations against her. So Islam is already ready. Dome is here. They already took over England. They already took over Egypt. They already took over Israel. Well, they're about to take over Israel. And this all must happen before they fall too. They have to conquer the system that be already. And once they do, then they're going to fall, because that highest, that Allah thing that they believe in is Satan. And remember, this is how I look at things. God is the judge. The Most High Ahaya is the judge. The angels is the jury. Those who should be making sure that the evidence is being weighed out and stuff. You know what I'm saying? The accuser would be the sin, because it's the sin that accuses you. Did you really commit this sin, or did you commit this sin? And the person who's standing at the defendant seat would be you. You see what I'm saying? And the sheriff would be Satan. And Satan is just a sheriff. Once you are judged and ruled guilty, and you are committed of the sin of the wrongdoing as a defendant before the Most High, Ahaya, and before the jury, the angels, the council of the angels, then you are sent to jail. So Satan is told, like a sheriff is told, arrest him, put him in handcuffs. He is going to jail for this amount of time. So Satan is appointed to over people to sentence them to jail the same way. As above, so below, as below, so above. You see what I'm saying? So it's the same system in the heavens, in the spiritual, that there is a court there too, a spiritual court. And it's the worst one you'll ever go to and the best one you'll ever go to, because it's just. It's just. You're rewarded with your own work and your own doing. So the Creator is preparing these satanic people, these sheriffs, these policemen, to implement the curse on you and the harshness on you. And at a point after they do all that, and that is fulfilled, like the Bible saying, the scriptures, then will they fall, when the children of Israel will go back to their place. So throughout this whole situation, the chosen people of the Most High will be guided through this whole situation, which may be you, which may be you, which may be me. If you're hearing this now, there's a great chance that's possible. One third will live, two thirds will die. Two thirds can be 2 million out of 3 million, and 1 million survives. That's crazy. How much people are there in this world? Two thirds. Whew. Let's continue. And it says that in the scriptures. So they're about to do it. They're doing it through the food, the abortions, the being gay, all that stuff. So you won't be able to reproduce, the chemtrails, the gardens not being able to grow. And oh man, whew. We're plagued here in America, guys. Babylon has fallen. We had fallen. So set up a standard in the lands, a law. Blow the trumpet among the nations. Alarm everyone. Let them know. Prepare the nations against her, like I'm doing now. I'm calling you guys to awaken. Call together against her, the kingdoms of Ararat. If you don't know who these people are, look them up, because it will let you know what nation they're saying is being sent here. So Ararat, Menini, and Ashkenaz, which is the Ashkenazis. They're already against us. Ararat is probably the Arabs, and Menini, Mennonite or whatever, is also a nation too, but I'm not sure who. So look these three names up, because they're the nations that will be coming against her, called against her. Appoint a captain against her, which will be the New World Order president type of thing. Cause the horses to come up like the bristling locusts. Prepare against her the nations with the kings of the Medes, their captains, and all their rulers, and all the land of their dominion. So all their associates, all their affiliates, all those united with the Medes are going to unite with these three too. And the land shall tremble in sorrow, for every purpose of Ahaya shall be performed against America, Babylon, and all the wicked places, as well as Arabia and Europe. So for every purpose of Ahaya shall be performed against Babylon, to make the land of Babylon a desolation without an inhabitant. The mighty men of Babylon have ceased to fight. So we have ceased to fight. We have stopped fighting against evil, and we accepted it. We stopped fighting against slavery. We accepted it. We're just accepting things, and that's making us drink the wine. Rather you die by not accepting it. Lawful rebelliousness. They have remained in their strongholds. Their might has failed. They became as woman. They have burned her dwelling places. Her bars are broken. So she has been raped. America has been raped, guys. It's done. She is a prostitute now. One post shall run to meet another, and one messenger to meet another, to show the king of Babylon, the president of America, president of all these wicked places, the leaders of all these wicked places, that his city is taken on every side. So we're going to get them from every side when the time comes. And that the fords are seized, and the reeds they have burned with fire, and the men of war are terrified. For thus says Ahaya of hosts, Ahaya, the Most High of Israel, Yesharala, the daughter of Babylon, is like a threshing floor. It is time to thresh her. Yet a little while, in the time of her harvest, shall come. So harvest, which you plant, is what will grow and what you'll get. What you sow is what you reap. What you reap is what you sowed. So what you plant is what you'll grow. So if you plant a rotten seed and you're trying to grow a rotten plant, you're going to have a rotten plant, rotten fruits, rotten everything. But if you plant a healthy seed, a heal thy seed, a positive seed, luminescent with light, pure bright white light, you see what I'm saying? Then you grow a plant with that pure white bright light. So therefore its fruits are filled up with pure white bright light, or pure bright white light, and will give off the vibration of that. So what you plant is what you get. What you give is what you receive. What you put in is what you get back. So we're literally getting paid with what we gave. Karma. What goes around comes back around. And now America is going to be treated like a floor mat, just like it treat everyone else like a floor mat. And Islam has been given the power to fulfill that. Islam, the Muslims, and Obama. He's here to fulfill the Antichrist purpose, the ones against us. Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, has devoured me. Nebuchadnezzar is an idol. You should look it up. It's an idol statue. They're going to be trying to raise that back up and stuff and crazy shit. Excuse my language. Forgive me. The king of Babylon has devoured me. He has crushed me. He has made me an empty vessel. He has swallowed me up like a monster. He has filled his belly with my delicacies. He has cast me out. The violence done to me and to my flesh be upon Babylon, shall the inhabitant of Zion say, and my blood upon the inhabitants of Chaldea, shall Jerusalem say. Therefore, thus says Ahaya, behold, I will plead your cause and take vengeance for you, and I will dry up her sea and make her springs dry. So the Creator heard everyone's crying and screaming about how America has done them wrong. America has done them wrong. America's robbing us. America's robbing us. America's raping us. America's raping us. England this, England that. America this, America that. Arabia this, Arabia that. They will all be shut down, completely shut down. And that's why the government shut down now, because they know Sam Big's coming. They're not going to tell people. They're going to let you work until you die. Because when that time comes, it's done. It will happen suddenly, instantly, all of a sudden. Behold, Bilal. You see? So get the heck out of here. Get out of here. Therefore, says Ahaya, behold, I will plead your cause and take vengeance for you. So all those in Islam will not be punished unless they start to stray away from what the Most High is telling them to do. You see? So they have to do what they're doing. They're devoted people. They're very devoted people. More than Christians. So therefore Christians are going to get slaughtered by them too. Like they said in Revelations, the beast was given the power to conquer, just to conquer. So it's coming. So make her springs dry. The water is going to dry. And Babylon should become a heap, a dwelling place for jackals, an astonishment and a hissing, without an inhabitant. They shall roar together like lions. They shall growl as lions' whelps. In their excitement, I will make their feast, and I will make them drunk, that they may rejoice and sleep a perpetual sleep, and not wake, says Ahaya. I will bring, that's why I got a lot of zombies around, mental zombies, because they're sleeping and they're in a perpetual sleep and just cannot wake up. They can't break free. They're being punished. A lot of people has already been sent to hell here, now, and present. And when they die, they'll be there fully in flesh and spirit. So if you're not in heaven now, you may not be in heaven later. If you do not repent, turn your ways, amend your direction, and accept Christ Yeshua as your savior. And Christ Yeshua is the resurrection of Ahaya, which came here, manifested in flesh, died for your sin in order to wipe away all your wrongdoing. Which means he made a covenant with the Most High, Ahaya. So I will bring them down like lambs to the slaughter. So a lot of people are sheeple now. Meh. Wherever Obama tells me to go, I'ma go, man. Whatever the president and whatever the priest and pastor tells me, I'ma do it, man. Straight into the slaughter, man. It's too late. Like rams with male goats. How is shishash taken? Look this up if you don't know what this means. Shishash. And how is the praise of the whole earth surprised? How has Babylon become an astonishment among the nations? The sea has come up upon Babylon. The sea is the ocean. She is covered with the multitude of its waves. Therefore, it's talking about a flooding again. Oh, man. I keep feeling this too. America, a lot of places in America is really going to be underwater, man. Not to, you know, build fear, but to put more trust in the Most High, higher. That you will be guided, that you will be safe. Be within the Ark of the Covenant. It is the ship. Her cities are a desolation, a dry land, and a wilderness, a wild nest. A land in which no man dwells, neither does any son of man pass by there. So America is going to be completely empty at some point. Completely empty. And you may not only want to be in the middle of America, because then you might be stuck in the middle of America, surrounded around the edges and coasts with threats, harm, all this stuff. So we got to completely get out of America. If I can, I'll find within the Bible. If you don't find it within the Bible and share with me yet, I will share with you where to go, because I'm pretty sure the Most High explains in the Bible where to go, in the scriptures. And we may run into it today. And I will punish Bel, Baal, Lucifer, Satan, all that stuff, Illuminati, Skull and Bones, the Council of 12, Majestic 12, the police, all them, Jesus, Jesus, Zeus, Jehovah, Yahweh, all them people are forms of Bel. And YHWH, which is the Tetragrammaton from the Ashkenazi Jews. They created to destroy us so we can worship their God and all that stuff. Everything leads to the Most High anyway, but it's not the Most High. Most High's chosen image. So therefore it's called Baal, 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 Babylon, Baal. And Babylon will be punished. So Satan will be punished. And I will bring forth out of his mouth that which he has swallowed up. So now the devil's gonna have to cough up all the spirits back to everyone, spit it all out, purge it all out, give it all back, release my people, let them go now. And they're all gonna come back. Just you're gaining a sense of I am and a sense of self and breath again. For once, the breath of life. And the nation shall not flow together anymore unto him. Yeah, the wall of Babylon shall completely fall. My people, go you out of the midst of her and deliver yourselves, every man his soul, from the fierce anger of Ahiah. Deliver me, give back, send it back. You had borrowed it, now ship it back. Deliver it back, redeem yourself. Accept for value yourself. Honor, I am. By becoming an I am presence and think, giving thanks to the Creator constantly every day. That's how you give back. Give thanks, give appreciation, give gratitude. Thank you, Ahaya, for the breath I breathe. Thank you, Ahaya, for letting me become aware of the things I'm hearing right now. Thank you, Ahaya. I am grateful for everything that you have made me today. I am that I am, and what I am is what I will always be. And what I am right now is what I was, and what I am and what I will be tomorrow. Thank you for making what it is, because what is what it is, and what it is what it will always be. I am grateful for all of these things and these concepts that you make me simply and basically aware of, which forms my foundation, which sets me upon the rock of you, but never above you. Always equal and below you, the Most High, higher. I am. I give it all back. This is all yours. I am borrowed. My time is borrowed without any to spend. I give it all back. Thank you. I will fulfill the promise to pay you back. My people, go you out of the midst of her and deliver yourself, every man his soul. Get back your soul. From the fierce anger of Ahia, and lest your heart faint. Your heart is going to go through trouble, grief, pain, being scared, nervous, confused. And you fear for the rumor that shall be heard in the land. So there's a lot of rumors about what may be happening and what may happen. So they're doing that to make your heart faint, to make you less confident. But you should always have a strong heart chakra, a strong spiritual heart, a higher heart. A rumor shall both come 1 year, and after that, in another year, shall come a rumor, and violence in the land, ruler against ruler. So there's going to be a rumor, just like on 9/11, they lied and said Iraq or Afghanistan caused all that, and they did that, it was Al-Qaeda, and it was a rumor, it was a lie. So this lie is going to be even greater. It's going to prepare us. It may be the whole fact that Islam is satanic. Although, I'm not saying they're not, I'm not saying they are, but it might be that type of rumor. To the point where they make people turn against Allah too, which might be the other form of the Most High or something like that. For just example. So only in your heart and in your own intuition you can tell what's true or not. But that certain rumor will cause violence in the land. Like setting blacks against whites and whites against black type of thing. Nation against nation. Kingdom against kingdom. Color against color. Ruler against ruler. Stupid stuff. Like Bloods and Crips all over. But it will all be stimulated by a rumor. That rumor will make the heart faint. It will make us feel grief, feel hurt, feel weak. And for when your heart is weak, you're in fear. So when you're in fear because of a rumor that was heard in the land, that's coming in one year at a time, 1 year after another, and you're hearing that there's a certain group doing this for 2 years straight, eventually people will fear, they'll get upset, and it will cause violence in the land. And that will cause them to do what they need to do, is rule other nations and lands by setting people against people while they take over their lands technically. The whole army is working for that cause. All the rumors, it's all the rumors that makes the army people want to join the army and the police force. And once they do, they're set against people that they tell them is bad. I don't know where they get that idea from, who can judge that, but they do it anyway, and the police and the army implement on it. So create violence, and these rulers who are ruling these people committing violence will really be fighting each other. So once all their army men is done, their army men is gone, then that ruler is going to take over the seat of that ruler. So they will fight for rulership. There will be a big war for power over earth, but then they'll all die. They're stupid. They'll be blinded fighting over the earth while the spiritual come and smite them. Therefore, behold, the days come that I will do judgment upon the graven images of Babylon, and her whole land shall be confounded, and all her slain shall fall in the midst of her. Then the heaven and the earth and all that is in them shall sing for Babylon, for the plunderers shall come unto her from the north, says Ahiah. From the north. As Babylon has caused the slain of Israel to fall, the slain of Yesharallah, the slain of the 12 tribes of Israel, Jacob and Isaac, so at Babylon shall fall the slain of all the earth. You that have escaped the sword, go away. Stand not still. Remember Ahiah afar off, and let Jerusalem come into your mind. We are ashamed because we have heard reproach. Shame has covered our faces, for strangers have come into the sanctuaries of Ahiah's house. The rabbis, the Ashkenazi Jews, claiming they're Jews, but they're not. The Bible speaks to this. And the Christians claiming that they're Christian in the name of Christ is shy, but then they're worshiping Zeus and calling Zeus Christ. Blasphemy. Complete blasphemy. Complete lust. And Allah does not mean I am in Islamic Muslim language. So how the heck you get the creator's name out of Allah? Blasphemies. Therefore, behold, the days come, says Ahiah, that I will execute judgment upon her graven images, and through all her land the wounded shall groan. Through Babylon, though Babylon shall mount unto heaven, and though she should fortify the height of her strength, yet from me shall plunderers come unto her, says Ahiah. A sound of a cry comes from Babylon, screaming, wailing, help, please, oh God, blah, all that stuff, and great destruction from the land of the Chaldeans. Because Ahiah has plundered Babylon and destroyed out of her the great voice, the presidents, all those speaking blasphemies and great things and false promises and stuff. Oh yeah, the Obamacare is going to take care of you guys, and these chips are going to keep you safe, even though we're going to track you everywhere, and we got to have these new cancerous metal detectors at the airport because it's going to keep you safe. We have to see right through your pants and your cars and your body using x-ray vision because we're protecting you. Oh, no, you don't want to use this medicine, although it worked, because we're protecting you. Like, what the heck? Get out of my face. You fucking liar. Pardon my language again, but seriously. The heck out my face. So, and destroyed out of her the great voice. When her waves do roar like great waters. This references to waters again. Waves do roar like great waters, or it can be waves of attack, everything happening all at once. A noise of their voice is raised, even more screaming and yelling, like what happened on Atlantis. So America is about to be sacrificed. Because the plunder, the new covenant, because the plunderer has become upon her, even upon Babylon, and her mighty men are taken. So all the honorable people I used to be honorable and justifiable and justifying and all that stuff, and all that stuff has fallen. They have all became dishonorable. Every police is dishonorable at this point. Every judge is dishonorable at this point. Every president, governmental person, all Congress is dishonorable at this point. And the honorable ones are being killed according to the scripture. That the saints will be prosecuted. They will be killed and destroyed and things like that by the beast once the time has come. And look, it is happening. Because the plunderer has come upon her, even upon Babylon, and her mighty men are taken, every one of their bows is broken. So there's no weapons. They're taking away our guns. We have nothing to protect ourselves. Like a bro, just as bad as a bow that's broken. You don't have your power. You don't know who I am. You don't have anything. Like, whoa, you're just left for dead completely, and you don't even know it. You're left for dead, my friend, if you do not leave here. You have been warned now and told, so spread the word, prepare the people, trust in the Most High, higher, or you will be kept here and punished because of your doubt and lack of trust. For Ahiah, the Most High, of recompenses shall surely repay. And I will make drunk her princes and her wise men, her captains and her rulers and her mighty men, and they shall sleep a perpetual sleep and not wake, says the king, whose name is Ahiah, the Most High of hosts. Ahiah, Ashur Ahiah. Jeremiah 51, section 58. Thus says Ahiah of hosts, the broad walls of Babylon shall be utterly broken, and her high gate shall be burned with fire. Her high gates shall be burned with fire, nuclear bombs, missiles, water shaking, floods, the coast. And the people shall labor in vain for Federal Reserve notes, for promise to pay notes, and it's never paid off. And while they're working for promises to pay that will never be paid off, which means they're not getting value, they're getting paper, another god or second idol, they will be burned while that work. They will be burned, and the money will be burned. The buildings will be burned. The job will be no more. Those who are in that place, that building at the time of the boom, just like 9/11, it will not stand no more. It will be gone. So therefore, they'll be laboring in vain, piling up earthly treasures that won't go with them once they get blown up and die. Which means they will instantly be sent to hell because they didn't get a chance to even accept the Most High Ahiah, Bahasham Yeshaya, in the name of the Most High Christ, the Redeemer, the Deliverer, the Avenger. And the nations, because of the fire, and they shall be weary. Jeremiah's message to Sariah. If you don't know who Sariah is, look who that is up. If you don't know who Jeremiah is, look that up too. All these names, you must take note and know who they are because they're pointing out to a nation. And look for the true name in Paleo-Hebrew. You see Paleo-Hebrew, and you'll find the ultimate truths. This is what I've been doing. The word which Jeremiah the prophet commanded Sariah, the son of Neriah, look that up. The son of Maaseiah, M-A-H-S-E-I-A-H, Maaseiah. When he went with Zedekiah, the king of Judah, into Babylon in the fourth year of his reign. So the word which Jeremiah the prophet commanded Seraiah, the son of Neriah, the son of Maaseiah, which he went with Zedekiah, the king of Judah, Yahawada, into Babylon in the fourth year of his reign. And this Seraiah was the quartermaster. So if you don't know what a quartermaster is, look that up as well. So I mean the master of the quarters. Quarters, seasons. So Jeremiah wrote in a book all the evil that should come upon Babylon, even all these words that are written against Babylon. And Jeremiah said to Seraiah, when you come to Babylon and shall see and shall read all these words, then shall you say, oh, Ahiah, you have spoken against this place to cut it off, that none shall remain in it. None, no one shall remain in it, neither man nor beast, no plant, nothing, just completely desolate. But that it shall be desolate forever, which means it might go underwater like Atlantis. This is gonna be a bumpy ride. Very bumpy. Very turbulent. And it shall be when you have finished reading this book that you shall bind a stone to it and cast it into the midst of the Euphrates. Look that up. Look where that's at as well. Because these things must be fulfilled and you might be one of the chosen ones. And you shall say, thus shall Babylon sink. Ah, you see, I keep saying that. I know it. It's going to sink. And shall not rise from the evil that I will bring upon her. And they shall be wary, curious, afraid, confused. They might stay here and still, like, I don't know if that's true, or man, it's just not resonating with me on that level. Yeah, I don't know if I should leave everything behind. Leave, flee, leave everything behind. Go as quick as you can, or just be ready to go home. Be ready to die, because this place is going to be placed underwater. It must be. Thus far as the words of Jeremiah. Pardon me. All right, let's continue. So as you can tell, the Creator is a creator of vengeance and war. Ezekiel 9, slaughter of the wicked. This is going to be the slaughter of the wicked. This one's a very short one, as you can tell. There's another part to it, though. He cried out in my ears with a loud voice, saying, cause them that have charge over the city to draw near, even every man with his destroying weapon in his hand. So everyone, grab your weapon, the weapon you're going to use to eliminate this thing, to erase, to be the eraser of the Most High, and draw near the city. And behold, six men came from the way of the higher gate, which lies towards the north, and every man a weapon for slaughter in his hand. And one man among them was clothed with linen, with the writer's ink horn by his side. So if you don't know what an ink horn is, look that up. A writer's ink horn. And they went in and stood beside the bronze altar, which would be the idol statue, because that's against the Most High. So the Most High is upset, like when Christ was upset and went to the cathedrals and the churches and broke all their statues and everything. They thought he was crazy. They thought he was a devil and mad because he was breaking their freaking statues. Of course they would think you're a devil because you're here to destroy them. You're the angel of the righteous and the devil to the devils because you're here to destroy them. They're no devil. They're nothing but a peasant, an energetic peasant. They don't have any energy to actually do anything, and they don't believe in the Most High to have any energy. They deny energy, spirit. They only believe in science. They're done. So they stood beside the bronze altar, Nebuchadnezzar, whatever you call it, Nebuchadnezzar. The glory of Ahiah, of Yesharala, of Israel, had gone up from the She-Rub. If you don't know what She-Rub mean, look it up, Cherub. Where it was, to the threshold of the house. The threshold of the house. This can also mean the zodiac signs as well, or the place where they're about to bring down. And he called to the man clothed with linen. Who is clothed in linen? Is it Aquarius, or what zodiac sign has linen, clothed with linen? Which had the writer's ink horn by his side. Ink horn, the writer's ink horn by his side. So a man clothed with linen. It is the threshold, which means the most highest house in the zodiac sign. And it has a writer's ink horn by its side. That's a picture. It might be, it might actually be Aquarius. Might be Aquarius, because Aquarius is at the top of the, well, we'll continue. Let's not translate into that yet. And the highest said unto him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that are done in its midst. And to the others he said in my hearing, go you after him through the city and kill. Let not your eyes spare, neither have you pity. Slay utterly old and young, both maidens and little children and women. But come not near any man upon whom is the mark, and begin as my sanctuary. Then they began at the elders who were before the house. So all those who were against the Most High were going to be slaughtered now, completely slaughtered. Yes, the creator said slaughtered. It's the slaughter of the wicked. So creator is a warrior-like person. It is based on justice, justification. You see what I'm saying? So, they have given the power to eliminate a certain group. King David had been given that power too. That's what made him reign for such a long time. Then they began at the elders who were before the house, in front of the house. And he said unto them, defile the house, rape them and things like that, and fill the courts with the slain, fill the floors with the slain. This is crazy. This is what happened to the Hebrew Israelites too, because they disobeyed the covenant. So they got raped, all this stuff, and go you forth. And they went forth and killed in the city. And it came to pass while they were slaying them, and I was left, that I fell upon my face and cried and said, ah, Ahiah, the Most High, Ahiah, Asher, Ahiah, the Most High, will you destroy all the rest of Israel and your pouring out of your fury upon Jerusalem, upon the Chaldeans, the heathens, the Gentiles, the forgers, perjurers? Then said he unto me, the iniquity of the house of Israel, Yasharallah, and Judah, Yahawada, is exceedingly great. So this is why Israel had fell. So when we get in the covenant, this is how our enemies fall and have always fell. And the land is full of blood. Look at Israel today. And the city of perverseness. You see that everywhere today. For they say, Ahiah has forsaken the land, and Ahiah sees not. So, because they're doubting, and they have little faith, they're being punished. That's a sin. And as for me also, my eyes shall not spare, neither will I have pity, but I will recompense their way upon their heads. And behold, the man clothed with linen, which had the inkhorn by his side, reported the matter, saying, I have done as you have commanded me. So the Most High commands us to do things, and we must do it or we'll be punished. So let's go ahead and continue. We're almost done. 2 Kings, section 11. Athaliah and Joash. And when Athaliah, the mother of Ahaziah, look up this name and look up who is her daughter, Ahaziah, saw that her son was dead, she arose and destroyed all the royal heirs, all the royal families, all their people. But Jehosheba, Oh man, look up what this name really means. I believe this is Jehovah in a different way. Jehovah Sheba, which is part wicked person. The daughter of King Joram, sister of Uzziah. So these people are probably wicked. Took Joash, the son of Uzziah. So the sister of Uzziah, Joram, took Joash, the son of Uzziah, and stole him away from among the king's sons who were slain, which means kidnapped her. And they, kidnapped him. And they hid him, even him and his nurse, in the bedchamber from Athaliah, so that he was not slain. And he was with her hid in the house of Ahiah 6 years, in prison pretty much for 6 years. And Athaliah did reign over the land. In the seventh year, Jehoiada, once again, look up that name. It's important. Look for the name in Hebrew. Look for history. Sent and brought the rulers over hundreds with the captains and the guard, and brought them to him into the house of Ahiah, and made a covenant with them, and took an oath of them in the house of Ahiah, and showed them the king's son. So Ahiah, and took an oath of them in the house of Ahiah, and showed them the king's son. So Jehoiada was pretty much sent forth. Wait, in the seventh year, Jehoiada sent and brought the rulers over hundreds. So a whole army of people was appointed by Jehoiada under the command of Ahiah to send them to pretty much make a covenant with the Most High Ahiah, oath with Ahiah, the Most High, the Great I Am, to eliminate the king's son as well as the king. Pardon me, let's not jump to that yet, but we'll read. But that's what I believe is saying there. And showed them the king's son, and he commanded them, saying, this is the thing that you shall do. A third part of you that enter in on the Sabbath, you know what the day of the Sabbath is, because that's when it happened, near that time, shall even be keepers of the watch over the king's house. So they're going to be spying on the king, watching the king. And the third part shall be at the gate of Sur. So a third portion of that, over hundreds of people in that army was guarding these gates. So in the third part shall be at the gate of Sur, S-U-R, look that up. And the third part at the gate behind the guard. So another third is going to be behind the guard. So shall you keep the watch of the house, that it be not broken down. So make sure that they're all together, unified, that they're all there, and everyone stick together, so we can pretty much take them out. And two divisions of you that go forth on the Sabbath, even they shall keep the watch of the house of Ahiah about the king. And you shall surround the king, every man with his weapons in his hand, and he that comes within the ranks, let him be slain, and be with you the king as he goes out and as he comes in. So continue to kill the king's ranks, is people one by one by one, the police, all their people, their guards, and then eventually get to the king. Watch the king go in, watch the king go out, watch the president go in, watch the president go out, the people. And the captains over the hundreds did according to all things that Jehoiada the priest commanded. And they took every man his men that were to come on the Sabbath, with them that should go out on the Sabbath, and came to Jehoiada the priest. And to the captains over hundreds did the priests give King David spears and shields. So into the captains over hundreds did the priests give King David's spears and shields that were in the temple of Ahiah. And the guard stood, every man with his weapons in his hand, round about the king, from the right corner of the temple to the left corner of the temple, along by the altar where they worshiped the statues and all that, and the temple. And he brought forth the king's son, and put the crown upon him, and gave him the testimony, and they made him king, and anointed him, and they clapped their hands, and said, God, Ahiah, save the king. And when Athaliah heard the noise of the guard and of the people, she came to the people into the temple of Ahiah. And when she looked, behold, the king stood by a pillar, as the manner was. And the princes and the trumpeters by the king, and all the people of the land rejoiced and blew with trumpets. And Athaliah tore her clothes and cried, treason, treason! But Jehoiada the priest commanded the captains of the hundreds, the officers of the army, and said unto them, take her forth outside with the ranks, and he that follows her kill with the sword. For the priest had said, let her not be slain in the house of Ahiah. And they laid her and laid hands on her, and she went by the way by which the horses came into the king's house, and there was she slain. And Jehoiada made a covenant between Ahiah and the king and the people, that they should be the Lord's, they should be Ahiah's people, between the king also and the people. So all right, so I was pretty much wrong about that. They were pretty much there to protect King David. Taking a look at this part again real quick. Okay, so I see Athaliah might be the bad person, and Jehoiada or Joash is probably the good person. So Jehoiada were the ones guarding pretty much King David to protect them from intrusion. But once again, I'm not going to jump to conclusion. I'm still learning, and I'm openly, you know, expressing these things. So make sure you do some research too on these things. So she was slain, Athaliah. And Jehoiada made a covenant between Ahiah and the king and the people, that they should be the Ahiah's people, between the king also and the people. And all the people of the land went into the house of Baal, and broke it down, in the house of the devil, used for all the idol worship, and broke it down, destroy it, annihilate it, and its altars and its images broke they in pieces thoroughly, and slew Matan, the priest of Baal. Look who Matan is. He was the priest, the voodoo priest of Baal, before the altar. So he was killed right there in front of his own altar. The priest appointed officers over the house of Ahiah, and he took the rulers over hundreds, and the captains, and the guard, and all the people of the land. And they brought down the king from the house of Ahiah, and came by the way of the gate of the guard to the king's house. And he sat on the throne of the kings, and all the people of the land rejoiced. And the city was quiet, because they slew Athaliah with the sword at the king's house. 7 years old was Jehoash when he began to reign. Shijewash. Let's go ahead and continue. Hope you guys are learning a lot from this. Alright, Job 20. Zophar answers again. And this is all proof to that the creator has a warrior-like personality, that you must be balanced. There's a season for everything. A time to be peaceful and a time to kill. And right now, it's a time to be peaceful and a time to kill all at once, because you will be attacked. You see what I'm saying? You will be attacked nonstop by the hundreds, by the millions. So someone's going to have to do something. Believe me or not, I don't care. Then answered Zophar. Look up what that mean. All these names I'm about to say, make sure you look them up. Zophar, the Naamathite, and said, if you don't know what Naamathite is, look it up. And said, therefore do my thoughts cause me to answer, and for this I make haste. So you're quick to speak because your thoughts cause you to answer. I have heard the rebuke of my reproach, and the spirit of my understanding causes me to answer. Know you not this of old, since man was placed upon the earth, that the triumphing of the wicked is short, and the joy of the hypocrite but for a moment? Though his haughtiness mounts up to the heavens, and his head reaches into the clouds. Yet he shall perish forever like his own refuse. They who have seen him shall say, where is he? He shall fly away as a dream, so all these wicked people, and shall not be found. Yea, he shall be chased away as a vision of the night. The eye also which saw him shall see him no more, neither shall his place any more behold him. His children shall seek to please the poor, and his hands shall restore their goods. So who has that type of power for their rich kids seeking to please the poor and feed the poor and stuff like that and restore the goods? Their own children will be part of the healing. His bones are full of the sin of his youth, which shall lie down with him in the dust. Though wickedness be sweet in his mouth, though he hide it under his tongue. Obama's constantly lying. Even the Muslim Arab people leaders be lying to them. Though he spare it and forsake it not, but keep it still within his mouth, yet his food in his body is soured. It is the gall of asp within him. So if you don't know what gall mean, look it up. And if you don't know asp mean apps, look it up. He has swallowed down riches, and he shall vomit them up again. Ahiah shall cast them out of his belly. He shall suck the poison of asp. The viper's tongue shall slay him. He shall not see the vipers, the brooks flowing with honey and butter. Remember, Satan, the viper, the snake, the serpent is working for the judge, the Most High, and is working for the jury, which is the angels. So he is the sheriff, the one appointed to punish you and lead you to your cell, to hell. So know that even Satan's working for the Most High. Although those who are working for Satan are those who are punished already. They have nothing to lose anymore, so they're used to lose more and take out those who are wicked. He shall not see the rivers, the brooks flowing with honey and butter. That which he labored for shall be he restore. Honey and butter can mean good feelings, positive feelings, bliss, happiness, truth, light, things like that. You know, the brooks flowing with honey and butter. So that which he labored for shall he restore, and shall not swallow it down. For the proceeds of business he shall not rejoice, because he has oppressed and has forsaken the poor. Who has oppressed and forsaken the poor? Our leaders, the rich people, all of them. They're going to puke it back out. Because he has violently taken away a house which he built not, the tribe of Israel, the house of the Lord, the Most High, Ahiah. Surely he shall not feel quietness in his heart. He shall not save of that which he desired. Nothing accumulate will go with him, and and he will not feel quietness in his heart, which means his thoughts will be loud. His heart will bother him, and he'll try all types of ways and all types of drugs to cope with it, and won't be able to. You see? So there shall none of his food be left. Therefore shall no man look for his goods. In the fullness of his sufficiency, he shall be in distress. Every hand of the wicked shall come upon him. When he is about to fill his belly, Ahiah shall cast the fury of his wrath upon him. People's going to want to beat him up, kick him. Oh, you're the one who fucked up everything and ruined the world. Pardon me for my language. Get him. And shall rain it upon him while he is eating. He shall flee, which means he won't get rest and won't be able to even eat. He shall flee from the iron weapon, the gun, and the bow of bronze shall strike him through. The bow of the bullet looked like a bow and arrow, a bullet of bronze, an iron weapon. It is drawn, you draw your gun, you draw a weapon, and comes out of the body, bow, gunshot. Yeah, the glittering sword, the gun, the spark of the gun it represents the sword too, comes out of his gall. Terrors are upon him. He is terrified. He's been shot at, stabbed, cut, kicked everywhere, ridiculed. Get out of our country. You're the one who ruined it. Get out of here. You lied to us. Get out of here. The whole planet, no matter where he goes, just stone rock. All darkness shall be laid up for his treasures. A fire not blown upon shall consume him. It shall go ill with him who is left in his tent. Those who are left in his territory and place will go through his plagues too. The heaven shall reveal his iniquity, and the earth shall rise up against him. We are the earth. The increase of his house shall depart, which means army will fall apart and be limited and minimized. Decrease. And his good shall flow away in the day of his wrath. This is the portion of a wicked man from Ahiah, and the heritage appointed unto him by Ahiah. Alright, let's go ahead and continue. One more at the end. So 1 Chronicles section 12. King David's army grows. So the king of Israel began to grow, the whole army. So we used to be a big military army for the Most High, though, of love and peace. We did our best to live as holy as we can, but when wickedness was caused, wickedness had to be done. Now these are they that came to David to Ziklag. If you don't know what Ziklag mean, look it up. While he yet kept himself close because of Saul, the son of Kish. So look up who Saul is. He was one of the leaders of the Israel tribe as well. And look up who Kish is. And they were among the mighty men, helpers of the war. They were armed with bows and could use both the right hand and the left hand in hurling stones and shooting arrows out of a bow, even of Saul's brethren of Benjamin, Banyamyan, the Trinidadians, Jamaicans, Caribbean people. The chief was Izer. If you don't know who that is, then look it up. Then Joash, as we read about recently, the sons of Shema, the Gibeathite, and Jeziel. Look that up if you don't know who Jeziel is. And Pelet. So these are the chiefs. The sons of Azmaveth. And Baraka. And Jehu. The Anthonite. So look that up. These are all the nations and stuff. Look at who they are. Research it. So these are all the people who are part of the army of King David. And Ishmael, the Gibeonite, a mighty man among the 30. A mighty man among the 30 and over the 30. And Jeremiah and Jahaziel. Look that up. Jahaziel and Johanan. Look that up. And Jozabad, the Gederathite, Aluze, and Jeremoth, and Belia, and Shemaria, and Sephatiah, the Harufite. So we have the Harufites, the Gederathites, the Anthatites, the tribe of Benjamin, and we'll continue. So now we have Eluze. Look up all these names. And Jeremoth, and Beulah, and Sheremaria, and Sarah, and Sephatiah, the Harufite. Elkanai, and Ishiah. And Azarel, and Jozer, and Jashobim, the Karotites. Look up their nations too. And Joliah, and Zebediah, the sons of Jeroham of Gedor. Look that up too. And the Gadites. There were and of the Gadites, there separated themselves unto David at the stronghold in the wilderness, men of might and men of war fit for the battle, that could handle shield and spear. Those faces were like the faces of lions, and were as swift of the gazelles upon the mountains, all in Africa. Ezer the first, or Obadiah the second, Eliab the third, look up these names, Mishmaniah the fourth, Jeremiah the fifth, Atai, the sixth. Eliel, the seventh. Johanan, the eighth. Elzabad, the ninth. And this is all part of the army. This is how thick our army was. Jeremiah, the tenth. Machbanai, the 11th. There were of the sons of God, which is the Indians of America, captains of the army. One of the least was over 100, and the greatest over 1,000. These are they that went over the Jordan in the first month, when it had overflown all its banks, and they put to fight all of them. And they put to flight all of them of the valleys, both toward the east and toward the west. And there came from the children of Banyamin, Benjamin, and Judah, Yahawada, to the stronghold unto David. And David went out to meet them, and answered and said unto them, If you are come peaceably unto me to help me, my heart shall be knit unto you. But if you are come to betray me to the enemies, seeing there is no wrong in my hand, Ahiah of our forefathers, look on it and rebuke it. Then the Spirit came upon Amaziah, who was chief of the captains. Amaziah, look that name up. And he said, Yours we are, David, and on your side, your son Jesse, peace be unto you, and peace be to your helpers. Look up what Jesse mean in Hebrew Israelite as well. For Ahiah helps you. For your Ahiah helps you. Then David received them and made them captains of his troop. And there deserted some of Manasseh, which is the Cubans, to David, when he came with the Philistines against Saul to battle. But they helped them not, for the lords of the Philistines, after counsel, sent him away, saying, He will desert to his master Saul, to the peril of our heads. So as we continue on and see, as he went to Ziklag, there deserted to him of Manasseh, Adna, and Jozabad. Look up these names, Adna, Jozabad, and Jediel, and Michael, and Jozabad, and Elihu, and Zelote, captains of the thousands that were from Manasseh. And they helped David against the band of raiders, for they were all mighty men of valor, and were captains in the army. For at that time, day by day there came more to David to help him, until it was a great army, like the army of Ahiah. David's army at Hebron. Look up what Hebron mean if you don't know what it mean and where it's at. And these are the numbers of the men that were ready, armed for war, and come to David to Hebron, to turn the kingdom of Saul to him, according to the word of Ahiah. The children of Yahawada, the so-called Negroes, that bore shield and spear, were 6,800, ready armed for war. Of the children of Simeon, Simeon will be the Dominicans, mighty men of valor for war, 7,100. Let's not add these up. Of the children of Levi, the Haitians, Haitians, Lawaya, 4,600. And Jehoiada was the leader of the Aaronites, and with him were 3,700. 3,700. And Zadok, a young man mighty of valor, of his father's house, 22 captains. So 22 captains. And of the children of Banyamin, Benjamin, the Caribbean, Trinidadians, Jamaicans, them people, Barbadian, the kindred of Saul, 3,000. For until now, the greatest part of them had remained loyal to the house of Saul. And of the children of Ephraim, 20,800 mighty men of valor, famous men throughout the house of their fathers. Ephraim would be the Boricuas, the Puerto Ricans. 20,800 mighty men. It's a lot of people. And of the half-tribe of Manasseh, 18,000 who were designated by name to come and make David king. And of the children of Issachar, which is the Mexicans, the Mayans, who were men that had understanding of the times, to know what Israel, Yesharela, ought to do. The heads of them were 200, and all their brethren were under their command. Of Zebulun, such as went forth to battle, expert in war. Zebulun, who is Zebulun again? I have to remember, pardon me, let me look that up real quick. Bada bing, bada boom. Alright, let's look into here and see it. Boom. Hold on 1 second. Should be it right here. Zubelon, Guatemala to Panama. Panama, Guatemala. So the Guatemalans. So of the Guatemalans, Zebulon, such as went forth to battle, expert in war, with all instruments, weapons of war, 50,000 who could keep ranks. They had singleness of heart. And of Naphtali, let's look up who Naphtali is. Naphtali, the Argentinians in Chile. So these are all the 12 tribes of Israel. And of Naphtali, 1,000 captains, and with them, with shield and spear, 37,000. So 37,000. And of the Danites, expert in war, 28,600. So 28,600. I don't know if they speak about Dan here, because he's not necessarily part of the 12 tribes, but they had help. All right, so the Danites. And on the other side of the Jordan, of the Rebuanites, which is probably Reuben would be the Seminole Indians. And the Gadites, which would be the North American Indians. Hold on. Let me see. Yeah, the North American Indians, Gadites. And of the half-tribe of Manasseh, the Cubans, were all with all manner of instruments of war for battle, 120,000. So 120,000 people. All these men of war that could keep ranks came with a perfect heart to Hebron to make David king over all Israel, Yesharela. And all the rest also of Israel were of one heart to make David king. And they were there with David 3 days, eating and drinking, for their brethren had prepared for them. Moreover, they that were near them, even from Issachar, the Mexicans, and Zebulun, which would be, the Indians. Okay, the Guatemalans in Panama. And Naphtali, which would be the Argentinians in Chile, brought food on donkeys, and on camels, and on mules, and on oxen, and supplies of meal, cakes of figs, and bunches of raisins, and wine, and oil, and oxen, and sheep abundantly. For there were joy in Israel, Yesharela. That was when we were abundant, because we were living under the command of the Most High. And the Most High was saying to make King David the king. That's what the Most High appointed. So everyone was feeling that, because they were under the same covenant and in the same voice. Alright, we're going to go ahead and finish up the rest of this right here. So this is Numbers 35, cities for the Levites, cities for the Haitians. So this is where the Haitians got Haiti and their land and their part in the whole 12 tribes of Israel. Hold on. So cities for the Levites, the Haitians, the Haitians. And Ahaya spoken to Mosaiz, Masha, in the plains of Moab, by the Jordan near Jericho, saying, command the children of Yesharala, Israel, that they give unto the Levites, the Haitians, of the inheritance of their possession, cities to dwell in. And you shall give also unto the Levites pasture, lawaya, pasture lands, for the cities round about them. And the cities they have to dwell in, and their pasture lands shall be for their cattle, and for their livestock, and for all of their animals. And the pasture lands of the cities, which you shall give unto the Levites, the Lawiyas, shall reach from the wall of the city, and outward, and outward, 1,000 cubits all around. 1,000 cubits all around. And you shall measure from outside the city of the east side, 2,000 cubits, and on the south side, 2,000 cubits, and on the west side, 2,000 cubits, and on the north side, 2,000 cubits. And the city shall be in the midst. This shall be to them the pasture lands for the cities. Because Haiti means the land of mountains. Cities of refuge. And among the cities which you shall give unto the Levites, there shall be 6 cities for refuge, which you shall appoint for the manslayer, that he may flee there. And to them you shall add 42 cities, 42 cities to the 6. So I'd be like 48, if that's what he meant. So all the cities which you shall give to the Levites shall be 48 cities. Yep, I was right, 48 cities. Them shall you give with their pasture lands. And the cities which you shall give shall be from the possession of the children of Yesharala. From them that have many, you shall give many. But from them that have few, you shall give few. Everyone shall give from his cities unto the Levites, according to his inheritance with which he inherits. And Ahaya spoke unto Masha, saying, speak unto the children of Yesharala, and say unto them, When you are come over Jordan into the land of Canaan, then you shall appoint you cities to be cities of refuge for you, that the slayer may flee there, who kills any person unintentionally. And they shall be unto you cities for refuge from the avenger, that the manslayer die not, until he stands before the congregation in judgment. And of these cities which you shall give, 6 cities shall you have for refuge. You shall give 3 cities on this side of Jordan, and 3 cities shall, pardon me, and 3 cities shall you give in the land of Canaan, which shall be cities of refuge. These 6 cities shall be a refuge, both for the children of Yesharala, and for the stranger, and for the sojourner among them, that everyone that kills any person unintentionally may flee there. So it's telling you where to go right there. These are keys right there, the chosen places to go. But if he strikes him with an instrument of iron so that he dies, which is a gun or something like that, he is a murderer. The murderer shall surely be put to death. And if he strikes him with throwing a stone, by which he may die, and he dies, he is a murderer. That is different than someone protecting yourself and they unintentionally, you know, kill them. The murderer shall surely be put to death. Or if he strikes him with a hand weapon of wood, a baton, things like that, by which he may die, and he dies, he is a murderer. The murderer shall surely be put to death. The avenger of blood himself shall slay the murderer. When he meets him, he shall slay him. But if he pushes him from hatred or hurls at him by lying in wait, that he dies. Or in enmity strikes him with his hand and he dies, he that struck him shall surely be put to death, for he is a murderer. The avenger of blood shall slay the murderer when he meets him. But if he pushes him suddenly without enmity, or has cast upon him anything without lying in wait, or use any stone by which a man may die, seeing him not, and cast it upon him that he dies, and was not his enemy, neither sought his him harm. So pardon me, let me read that again. So, but if he pushes him suddenly without enmity, or has cast upon him anything without lying in wait, or use any stone by which a man die, seeing him not, and cast it upon him that he dies, and was not his enemy, neither sought his harm, then the congregation shall judge between the slayer and the avenger of blood according to these judgments. So the slayer will be someone who killed innocent people in vain, and the avenger will be here, the one who is here to punish and justify what the slayer has caused and done wrong. So there are beasts of beasts and devils of devils. You see what I'm saying? Destroyer of destroyers, King of kings, Lord of lords. And the congregation shall deliver the slayer out of the hand of the avenger of blood. And the congregation, the court, shall restore him to the city of his refuge where he had fled. And he shall abide in it until the death of the high priest, who was anointed with the holy oil. But if the slayer shall at any time come outside the border of the city of his refuge where he had fled, and the avenger of blood finds him outside the borders of the city of his refuge, and the avenger of blood kills the slayer, he shall not be guilty of blood. This is Numbers 35, section 28 now. Hold on one second. Because he have remained in the city of his refuge until the death of the high priest. But after the death of the high priest, the slayer shall return into the land of his possession as well. So life in jail is against the law too. So these things shall be for a statute of judgment. So these are a statute unto you throughout your generations in all your dwellings. So it is a law as part of the commandment. Whoever kills any person, the murderer shall be put to death by the mouth of witnesses. But one witness shall not testify against any person to cause him to die. No false witness. Do not bear false witness. Moreover, you shall take no ransom for the life of a murderer. You shouldn't be getting paid for being a judge and things like that. You know what I'm saying? You shouldn't be getting a ransom for the life of a murderer, or being paid for the murderer to get out, like bail and stuff like that. About, you know, makes no sense when they're guilty of death. But he shall be surely put to death if they let him out of that jail, which is his refuge. And you shall take no ransom for him that is fled to the city of his refuge, that he should come again to dwell in the land until the death of the priest. So you shall not pollute the land in which you are, in the land in which you are, for blood defiles the land, and the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, except by the blood of him that shed it. Live by the sword, you die by the sword. Defile not therefore the land which you shall inhabit, wherein I dwell, for I, the Most High, I am that I am, dwell among the children of Yesharallah, of Israel. Alright, so we're almost done, everyone. Let's go ahead and read Numbers 36, the inheritance of daughters of Zelophehad. So write that name down if you don't know what that means. Zelophehad. And the chief fathers of the families of the children of Gilead, and the son of Machar, the son of Manasseh, of the families of the sons of Joseph, came near and spoke before Masha, Moses, and before the leaders, the chief fathers of the children of Yesharallah. And they said, Ahiah commanded my lord to give the land for all inheritance by lot to the children of Yesharallah. So by Lot, as you know, Lot is also found in the land of Canaan, of the Canaanite land. And they said, the Lord commanded my Lord to give the land for all an inheritance by Lot to the children of Yesharallah. And Ahiah was commanded by Ahiah to give the inheritance of Zelophehad, our brother, unto his daughters. And if they are married to any of the sons of the other tribes of the children of Yesharallah, then shall their inheritance be taken from the inheritance of our fathers, the forefathers, and shall be put to the inheritance of the tribe to which they are received. So shall it be taken from the lot of our inheritance. And when the jubilee of the children of Yesharallah shall be, then shall their inheritance be put into the inheritance of the tribe to which they are received. So shall their inheritance be taken away from the inheritance of the tribe of our forefathers and foremothers. And Masha commanded the children of Yesharallah, according to the word of Ahiah, saying, the tribe of the sons of Joseph had spoken correctly. This is the thing which Ahiah does command concerning the daughters of Zelophehad, saying, let them marry to whom they think best, only to the family of the tribe of their forefathers, their fathers, shall they marry. So shall not the inheritance of the children of Yesharallah move from tribe to tribe. For every one of the children of Yesharallah shall keep to himself the inheritance of the tribe of his forefathers. And every daughter that possesses an inheritance in any tribe of the children of Yesharallah shall be wife unto one of the family of the tribe of her forefathers, that the children of Yesharallah may enjoy every man the inheritance of his forefathers. So now we have a common forefather lineage. You see, where we can live by the commandments and the laws of it without it, without us converting to someone else's belief, someone else's forefather's belief, even though we all have the same forefathers, to tell you the truth. Neither shall the inheritance move from one tribe to another tribe, but every one of the tribes of the children of Israel, Yesharallah, shall keep to himself his own inheritance, even as Ahiah commanded Masha, Moses. So did the daughters of Zelophehad. From Mala, Tirzah, and Hogla, and Milcah, and Noah, the daughters of Zelophehad. So look up those names too. Were married into their father's brother's sons. Their father's brother's sons. So their great uncles, four uncles, sons, and forefathers, and things like that. And they were married into the families of the sons of Manasseh, the son of Joseph. And their inheritance remained in the tribe of the family of their father. These are the commandments and the judgments which Ahiah commanded by the hand of Moses, Masha, unto the children of Israel, Yesharallah, and the plains of Moab, by the Jordan near Jericho. So this is where this commandment was set and done. Alright, we're almost done. Hope you guys are enjoying this. It's been quite an interesting journey, knowing this side of the Creator. Nehemiah 4, opposition to the rebuilding. Take a deep breath, relax your mind, calm your vessel, and be at peace with everything you're hearing. You're a warrior of the light. Nehemiah 4, opposition to the rebuilding. But it came to pass that when Sanballat, whoever that is, look it up, heard that we built the wall, he was angry and felt great indignation, and mocked the Jews, the Hebrew Israelites. And he spoke before his brethren in the army of Samaria, and said, what do these feeble Jews, these Hebrew Israelites, will they fortify themselves? Will they sacrifice? Will they finish in a day? Will they revive the stones out of the heaps of the rubbish which are burned? Now, Tobiah, look that up. The Ammonite was by him, and he said, even that which they build, if a fox goes up, or a wolf, or a liar, or a trickster, or a deceiver, he shall even break down their stone wall. Hear, O our Ahiah, for we are despised, and turn their reproach upon their own head, and give them for a spoil in the land of captivity. This is all towards our enemy. And cover not their iniquity, their sins and wrongdoing. Bless you. And let not their sin be blotted out from before you. For they have provoked you to anger before the builders. I am. So built we the wall. So he began to build the wall. And all the wall was joined together unto the half thereof. For the people had a mind to work. They had a mind. They thought. They were thinkers. They were imaginative, inspired thinkers. Very creative. But it came to pass that when Sanballat and Tobiah and the Arabians and the Ammonites and the Ashdodites, look up those names too, heard that the walls of Jerusalem were being repaired and that the breaks began to be closed, then they were very angry. These four tribes, got to watch out for them. And conspired of them together. So they worked together to try bring it down, to come and to fight against Jerusalem and to hinder it. Nevertheless, we made our prayer unto our Ahiah and set a watch against them day and night because of them. And Judah, Yahawada, said, the strength of the bearers of burdens is failing, and there is much rubbish, so that we are not able to build the wall. And our adversary said, they shall not know, neither see, till we come in the midst among them and slay them and cause the work to cease. And they've been doing that to many people. I won't be surprised if my body end up in the ocean type of thing. Because I am a Hebrew Israelite. I am a firm believer of Christ Yeshua, and I will always remember what he went through to pay for my sins with his flesh and blood. Through his pain, his sacrifice, I will always remember that. Ahiah sent his only son, Yeshua, to die for my sins. Thou shalt not take it in vain. And it came to pass that when the Jews, Hebrew Israelites, who dwelt near them came, they said unto us 10 times, from all places where you shall return unto us, they will be upon you. Therefore set I in the lower places behind the wall, and on the higher places I even set the people according to their families, their forefathers, their tribes, with their swords, their weapons, their spears, and their bows. And I looked and rose up and said unto the nobles, and to the rulers, and to the rest of the people, be not afraid of them. Remember, Ahiah, I am that I am, Ahiah, Asher, Ahiah, Baasham, Yeshua, who is great and awesome, and fight for your brethren, your sons and your daughters, your wives and your houses. And it came to pass when our enemies heard that it was known unto us, and Ahiah had brought their counsel to nothing, to complete rot, that we returned all of us to the wall, everyone unto his work. So now that they were eliminated, the enemy was eliminated, whatever way they were eliminated, everyone returned to their work, creating the wall like Ahiah told them to do, before then parasites tried getting away. And it came to pass from that time forth that the half of my servants worked in the work, and the other half of them held the spears, the shields, and the bows, and the armor, and the rulers supported all the house of Judah, Yahawada, the lion awakes. So, as you can tell, as they were working on the wall, they had to have an army protect them at the same time. So how can you have peace when you don't have soldiers to protect the peace, to protect that? You know what I'm saying? They gotta be soldiers in a peaceful nation, tribe. They who built on the wall, and they that bore burdens, so burdened themselves. Everyone with one of his hands worked in the work, and with the other hand held a weapon. For the builders, everyone had his sword girded by his side, and so built. And he that sounded the trumpet was by me. And I said unto the nobles, and to the rulers, and to the rest of the people, the work is great and large, and we are separated unto the wall, one far from another. And whatever place therefore you hear the sound of the trumpet, come you there unto us. Our Ahiah shall fight for us. So we labored in the work, and half of them held the spears from the rising of the morning till the stars appeared. Likewise at the same time said I unto the people, let every one with his servant lodge, unite, combine, join, unify with Jerusalem, that in the night they may be a guard to us and labor during the day. So neither I, nor my brethren, nor my servants, nor the men of the guard who followed me, none of us put off our clothes, saving that everyone put them off for washing. So now you can read the next part of that if you want. I'm going to go ahead and continue. These are the last three sections that we're going to read. Alright, Romans 9. Paul's concern for Ahiah's people, Israel, Yesharela. I said the truth in Christ Yeshayah. I lie not, my conscience also bearing me witness in the holy, pure spirit, consciousness, energy, that I have great heaviness and continual sorrow, grief in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accrued from Christ Yeshayah for my brethren, my kinsmen, according to the flesh. Who are the Hebrew Israelites? To whom pertains the adoption and the glory and the covenants and the giving of the law and the service of Ahiah and the promises? Whose are the fathers and of whom all concerning the flesh of Christ Yeshayah came? The Hebrew Israelites. Who is over all? Ahiah, blessed forever. Amen. Ahiah's sovereign choice. Not as though the word of Ahiah has taken no effect, for they are not all Yesharela, Israel, who are of Israel, Yesharela, neither because they are the descendants of Abraham, are they all children, but in Isaac, shall your descendants be called. That is, they who are the children of the flesh, these are not the children of Ahiah, Asher, Ahiah. But the children of the promise are counted for the descendants. For this is the word of promise. At this time will I come, and Sarah shall have a son. I shall come into her, and Sarah shall have a son. And not only this, but with Rebekah also had conceived by one, even by our father Isaac. So look up Rebekah too if you don't know who she is. For the children being not yet born, neither having done any good or evil, that the purpose of Ahiah according to election might stand, not of works but of him that calls. It was said unto her, the elder shall serve the younger. As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau, the Europeans, have I hated. What shall we say then? Is there unrighteousness with Ahiah? Ahiah forbid. For he says to Masha, Moses, I will have mercy on whom I have mercy, and I will have compassion on whom I will have compassion. So then it is not of him that wills, nor of him that runs, but of Ahiah that shows mercy. For the scripture says unto Pharaoh, Ramses, Obama, all of them, even for this same purpose have I raised you up, that I might show my power in you, and that my name, Ahiah, Asher, Ahiah, I am that I am, might be declared throughout all the earth. Therefore has he mercy on whom he will have mercy, and whom he will be hardens. And whom he will he hardens. Who can question Ahiah? Who can test Ahiah? Who can ever touch the surface of Ahiah? You will say then unto me, why does he yet find a fault? For who has resisted his will? his will, the Most High's will. Nay, but, O man, who are you that replies against Ahayah? Shall the thing formed say to him that formed it, Why have you made me thus? Has not the potter power over the clay, of the same lump to make one vessel unto honor and another unto dishonor? What if Ahayah, willing to show his wrath and to make his power known, endured with much long suffering the vessels of the wrath fitted to destruction, and that he might make known the riches of his glory on the vessels of mercy which he had before prepared unto glory? Gentiles can also become Ahayah's people, even us whom he has called, not of the Jews only, which we're talking about the Hebrew Israelites, not the Ashkenazi Jews, they're not Jews. The white Jews are not Jews, but also of the Gentiles. So the Gentiles would be the Jews and those people and Christians. So it says, as he says also in Hosea, I will call them my people who are not my people, and her beloved who was not my beloved. And it shall come to pass that in the place where it was said unto them, You are not my people, there shall they be called the children of the living God. The children of the living Ahayah. The children of the living I am that I am. The almighty I am. Self, spirit, consciousness, energy that I am. Isaiah also cries concerning Yesharallah. Though the number of the children of Yesharallah be as the sand of the sea, a remnant shall be saved. That means only a portion of them will be saved. For he will finish the work and cut it short in righteousness. So half is going to be cut off. Because a short work with Ahayah make upon the earth. So some people have a short contract here with the Creator, and some people have a long contract with the Creator. Either way, everyone's fulfilling their contract. And as Isaiah said before, except Ahayah of hosts had left us as a descendant, we had been as Sodom and been made like unto Gomorrah. So Sodom and Gomorrah is a big story about how people been destroyed, just like the Babylonians, and they went through a lot of hell, just like Pharaoh Ramses and Pharaoh Obama, Akhenaten, all that stuff. So they're all gonna fall down just the same. So righteousness is of faith, not law. So faith is righteousness. Righteousness is faith. And righteousness and faith is law. But law is not righteousness and faith. Righteousness and faith is law. What shall we say then? That the Gentiles who followed not after righteousness have attained to righteousness, even the righteousness which is of faith? But Yesharallah, who followed after the law of righteousness, has not attained to the law of righteousness. Why? Because they sought it not by faith, but as it were by the works of the law. For they stumbled at the stumbling stone. As it is written, Behold, I lay in Zion a stumbling stone and rock of offense, and whosoever believes on him shall not be ashamed. All right, we're going to continue here. Romans 10. Yesharallah tries own righteousness. So now the Israelite people, the Hebrew Israelites, the 12 tribes started to pretty much create their own righteousness and lose the way of the Most High's righteousness. Pardon me. All right, let's continue. So, brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to Ahayah for Yesharallah is that they might be saved. For I bear them witness that they have a zeal for Ahayah, but not according to knowledge. For they, being ignorant of Ahayah's righteousness, and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted themselves unto the righteousness of Ahayah. Pardon me, I'm going back and forth with my child here. I love you, baby. Mwah. All right, for they, being ignorant of Ahiah's righteousness and going about to establish their own righteousness, have not submitted, surrendered, gave up themselves unto the righteousness of I am that I am, Ahiah, Ashur, Ahiah, the Most High, the Most High's will. For Christ Yeshua is the end of the law for righteousness to everyone that believes. For Moses, Masha, describes the righteousness which is of the law. So, Christ, Moses, that the man who does those things shall live by them. But the righteousness which is of faith speaks thus, say not in your heart, who shall ascend into heaven? That is, to bring Christ, Yeshua, down from above. Or who shall descend into the deep? That is, to bring up Christ Yeshua again from the dead. But what says it? The word is near you, even in your mouth and in your heart. That is the word of faith. So don't ask who's going to hell, who's going to heaven, when's God coming back, when blah, blah, blah. Don't ask all that, which we preach. Confess with mouth, believe in heart, with heart, whole-bodied heart, that if you shall confess with your mouth, if you confess with your mouth Mashiach, Christ, Yeshua, and shall believe in your heart that Ahiah has raised him, Christ Yeshua, from the dead, you shall be saved. For with the heart man believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. For the scripture says, whosoever believes on him, Christ Yeshua, shall not be ashamed. For there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek. For the same Lord over all, the same Ahiah I am over all, is rich unto all that call upon him. So Jews may be the Ashkenazi Jews with the Greeks, instead of the Hebrew Israelites and the Greeks. It can be that way too. We're all one. We're all the same. For whosoever shall call upon the name of Ahiah, Bahasham, Yeshua, shall be saved. Israel rejects Ahiah's message. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed and have faith in? And how shall they believe in him, Ahiah, sure, Ahiah, of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher, guru, teacher, all this stuff? And how shall they preach except they be sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings of good things. But they have not all obeyed the gospel. For Isaiah says, Ahiah, who has believed our report? So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of I am that I am, Ahiah. But I say, have they not heard? Yes, verily, their sound went into all the earth, and their words unto the ends of the world. But I say, did not Israel know? No. First Moses says, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation I will anger you. So it said, first Moses says, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation I will anger you. But Isaiah is very bold and says, I was found of them that sought me not. I was made manifest unto them that asked not after me. So I was found of them that sought me not. I was made manifest, I am, unto them that asked not after me, Ahiah. But to Israel he says, all day long I have stretched forth my hands unto a disobedient and contrary people. That's why we're being punished. Alright, final chapter and section we're reading today. This is Romans 11, section 1. A remnant believe by grace. I say then, has Ahiah cast away his people of Israel? Ahiah forbid. For I also am an Israelite, of the descendants of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin. Ahiah has not cast away his people, whom he foreknew. Do you not know what the scripture says of Elijah? How he makes intercession to Ahijah against Israel, saying, Ahijah, they have killed your prophets and dug down your altars, and I am left alone, and they seek my life. But what says the answer of Ahijah unto him? I have reserved to myself 7,000 men who have not bowed the knees to the image of Baal, Jesus, Zeus, the devil, Lucifer, the Baphomet, Malkut, all that crap. So I have reserved to myself, I am that I am, 7,000 men who have not bowed the knees to the image of blah, blah, blah. Even so, then at this present time also, there is a remnant according to the election of grace. So there's a remnant, a portion of people who has been elected, chosen to live by the grace and mercy and forgiveness of the Most High. And if by grace, then is it not more of works? And if by grace, then is it no more of works? Otherwise, grace is no more grace. But if it be of works, then is it no more grace? Otherwise, work is no more work. So work is work, grace is grace. Grace has nothing to do with work. Grace is not work, work is not grace. Grace is grace, work is work. Giving grace is being appreciative, grateful, and appreciative of what you have, what you receive, what you get. Especially when your dreams come true. God, give thanks, give it all back. What then? Israel has not obtained that which it seeks for, but the election has obtained it, and the rest were blinded. According as it is written, Ahijah has given them the spirit of slumber, eyes that they should not see, and ears that they should not hear, unto this day. Don't see, don't hear, don't say. If you ever heard of that, complete oppression, suppression, censorship. And David says, let their table be made a snare, and a trap, and a stumbling block, and a recompense unto them. Let their eyes be darkened, that they may not see, and bow down their back always. Salvation comes to Gentiles through Israel's fall. I say then, have they stumbled that they should fall? Ahijah forbid. But rather through their fall, salvation is come unto the Gentiles to provoke them to jealousy. Christians, all that stuff, Islamic people, Catholicism. Now, if the fall of them be the riches of the world and the diminishing of them the riches of the Gentiles, how much more their fullness? For I speak to you, Gentiles, since I am the apostle of the Gentiles, I magnify my office. If by any means I may provoke to envy them who are my flesh, and might save some of them. For if the casting away of them be the reconciling of the world, what shall the receiving of them be but life from the dead? For if the first fruit are holy, the lump is also holy. And if the root is holy, so are the branches. And if some of the branches were broken off, and you, being a wild olive tree, were grafted in among them, and with them partake of the root and fatness of the olive tree, boast not against the branches. But if you boast, you bear not the root, but the root you. You will say then, the branches were broken off, that I may be grafted in, drafted in. Well, converted in. Well, because of unbelief, they were broken off, and you stand by faith. Be not arrogant, but fear. For if Ahijah spared not the natural branches, take heed lest he also not spare you. Behold, therefore, the goodness and severity of Ahijah. On them who fell, severity, but toward you, goodness. If you continue in his goodness, otherwise you also shall be cut off. Christianity, the Gentiles, used to be a good thing. It changed. It's all about money now and keeping the church up. lies and deception, all that's Satan. Just a little bit of that is Satan. Just a little bit of lying and all that's Satan. Just a little bit. Just a little bit of lying. Just to put food on the table and live another day. Just, yeah, that's Satan. Yes, that's it. So many of the Christians and Hebrew Israelites and everybody all across the world fell. Every nation. Even Islam used to be a positive nation at one point. I believe. And they also, if they abide not still in unbelief, shall be grafted in, for Ahiah is able to graft them in again. For if you were cut out of the olive tree, which is wild by nature, and were grafted contrary to nature into a good olive tree, how much more shall these who are the natural branches be grafted into their own olive tree? So they're being converted into Hebrew Israelites. They live, die like one, everything. They get the reward like one, everything. So this ain't against anybody. It's just that the Creator chose a certain nation because they were already holy. They were already pure. They were the image of what He had in mind. And, you know, He did His best to keep them as pure and clean as they can. But there's this other side that keep trying to fight with us and bring us down and make us turn against the Creator and break the laws through their own laws and statutes and ordinances. So all Israel shall be saved. For I would not, brethren, that you should be ignorant of this mystery, my story. Least you should be wise in your own conceits, that blindness in part is happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles come in. And so all Israel shall be saved, as it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer, Zion, and which would mean America, Babylon. One of the people from these bad cities and places will deliver, which is Yeshua, He that delivers. My God delivers. My God saves. My Ahiah saves. I am saves. My I am present saves. My I am who I am, that I am saves. And shall turn away ungodliness, ungodliness from Jacob, Israel. For this is my covenant unto them, when I shall take away their sins. Covenant. All these are covenants, part of the contract, the terms and the agreements. And the Bible is the book of the laws, the commandments. As concerning the gospel, they are enemies for your sakes. But concerning the election, they are beloved for the Father's sakes. For the gifts and calling of Ahiah are unchangeable. For as you in times past have not believed Ahiah, yet have now obtained mercy through their unbelief, even so have these also now not believed, that through your mercy they also may obtain mercy. For God has concluded them, Ahiah has concluded them, all in unbelief, that he might have mercy upon all. So doxology. Oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of Ahiah. How unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. For who has known the mind of Ahiah the Most High? Or who has been his counselor? Or who has first given to him, and it shall be recompensed unto him? For of him and through him, Ahiah, Asher, Ahiah, Bahasham, Yeshaya, Barakanta, and to him are all things, to whom be glory forever. Eternal. Amen. All right. Thank you so much, guys, for being here with me today and reading this with me. Now you get it that our Creator is a warrior. We're words of light. We're words of love. Love come first. Peace come first. Joy come first. Righteousness come first. And you must place the most high I am before everything. Before we leave, I want to leave with this prayer. Please close your eye. Just relax. Calm down your breath. Let your mind go. And know that everything instantly happens once it's said, like magic. Father in heaven, Ahiah, Asher, Ahiah, we thank you for this wonderful and holy day. We thank you for the strength and encouragement that you give us in each moment, in each lesson, in each message that you deliver to us. May you continue to use your people to awaken the other brothers and sisters on this planet. May we all finally see and experience peace firsthand for ourselves and be in that heavenly garden of Eden, which dwells in our inner temple. May our heart expand and to reach out to the things that we normally don't embrace so we can find that yin and yang balance in our life of war and peace and be walking the middle path to you like a key going into a door. May you continue to unlock our consciousness and teach us what truth is and what truth is not and help us know how to present that truth in the form of light and utteringness of speech and communication. May you teach us how to properly and perfectly utter the truth to others so they can receive the truth through our vibrations, which moves in waves through our emotions, energy, and motion from one thought to another telepathically, empathically, heart to heart, thought to thought, and stomach to stomach. May you continue to guide us and keep us safe and keep our family within your ark and your covenant. And may you continue to keep our head up and keep our consciousness and soul clean, clear of any void, clear of any harm, clear of any unrighteousness, for we are righteous people. In our holy name, Ahaya, Ashur, Ahaya, the great I am, that I am, I am, I am, I am, I am Yeshaya, the Redeemer, the Avenger, the Savior, our Deliverer. Christ Yeshaya is our salvation. In our holy name, we humbly pray, speak, give gratitude, thanks, and grace. Amen. Shalom, everyone. May you continue to live in peace. Barakanta, which means bless you. May your life continue to be fruitful and prosperous. Protect yourself when the time comes.